Vaheguru Ji Ka Khalsa, Vaheguru Ji Ki Fateh. The title of my poem is Sikh Women. Guru Nanak Dev Ji, the founder guru of the Sikhs. Guru Nanak Dev Ji, the founder guru of the Sikhs, who established the Sikh faith in the 15th century, thus declared, O people, listen. You say the king is above the sin, that he is virtuous, and whatsoever he may do, he can never be called a sinner. Guru Nanak Dev Ji, the founder guru of the Sikhs, who established the Sikh faith in the 15th century, thus declared, O people, listen. You say the king is above the sin, that he is virtuous, and whatsoever he may do, he can never be called a sinner. How can you believe that the king, yes, your emperor, is above sin, and yet the dear woman who gives birth to that king, the supreme emperor, and to many other saints and scholars, is held to be lower than the lowly, and she is inferior. He admonished the men folk and said, You are conceived by a woman, and the same woman gives you birth. You fall in love, get engaged and married to a woman. You gain respect in the society only when a woman is your companion. If your first wife dies, you look for another. You have all relations because of her. And how dare you say that she is sunken? She is deficient and insignificant. She is as low as the shoe on your feet, and she should always meet your needs. She should do as she is told, and just in case she breathes liberty and she tries to show her womanhood, then by force she should be kept in her place. When she is a child, her father is responsible. When she is a child, her father is responsible. When a young maiden, the husband is the commander. When she is old, her sons take over, and all through her life, she has to obey the orders of men. She is never free, but is always told what she can do, where she can go, and whom she can meet. Then Guru Amar Das Ji, the third guru of the Sikhs in the 16th century, condemned most strongly the evil practice of sati. Then Guru Amar Das Ji, the third guru of the Sikhs in the 16th century, condemned most strongly the evil practice of sati, a miserable tradition of those days in the society, that declared, if a husband dies before his wife, then she should be burnt alive with her husband on his funeral pyre. But if it should happen the other way around, and the wife dies leaving her husband behind, then the code was different, the rules were changed, and he didn't have to be burnt alive with her on the flame, but was free to find another woman and marry again. Guru Amar Das Ji, the third guru of the Sikhs, didn't like this abhorred practice against women, and he proclaimed, they are not satis who are cremated alive with their husbands. They are not satis who are cremated alive with their husbands, but the real satis are the ones who struggle on with their lives as a memorial to honor their loved ones. Life is a gift bestowed by the God, and in making full use of it, we illustrate good morals. Life is a gift bestowed by the God, and in making full use of it, we illustrate good morals. Yet others said, she is not pious, so she is not allowed to pray in the mosque. Yet others said, she is not pious, so she is not allowed to pray in the mosque. And if you need a witness in a legal case, one man's testimony is sufficient, but two women are needed to give evidence as if the woman was half a man. Then there is the saying that this lovely creature called Eve was only made by God to entertain Adam. That this lovely creature called Eve was only made by God to entertain Adam, and she was created from one of his ribs. And she is also responsible for them to be thrown out of the heavenly garden. And she is also responsible for them to be thrown out of the heavenly garden. Then there is a saying that this lovely creature called Eve was only made by God to entertain Adam, and she was created from one of his ribs, as if she has no individuality of her own. And she is also responsible for them to be thrown out of the heavenly garden. She is not at all equal to the man, so she should keep her place and follow his directions. If the two go riding, she should ride behind. She is not very clever. This should always be kept in mind. Her place is in the kitchen and bringing up the children. Guru Amar Das Ji created 22 manjis. Guru Amar Das Ji created 22 manjis, the seeds of preaching set up to spread Sikhi and the message of Guru Nanak. His three golden principles for a simple way of life: earn your living by honest means and share your income with all who need, and always remain in the presence of God, Waheguru, Waheguru, the Almighty Lord. When appointing the preachers, he chose some women along with their brothers to preach Sikh religion. The 10th Guru of the Sikhs, Guru Gobind Singh, created the Khalsa, the team of pure beings, the Panth Khalsa, the Khalsa family, the true fraternity. He declared that all the women were his daughters and he was their father. He declared that all the women were his daughters and he was their father. He named them Kaurs, the great princesses. He initiated them into the Khalsa Panth, giving them Amrit, the heavenly nectar, side by side as equal to their brothers, who were named Singhs, the mighty lions. Then these beautiful princesses, these brave lionesses, picked up their swords and fought in the battles along with the menfolk. They loved their father as they loved their faith, and they gave up their lives yet were never afraid. They could defend themselves, they could do anything. They felt equal to the men, being honored and blessed by their Guru, Guru Gobind Singh. Look at us, the Sikh women of today. We are equal to men in each and every way. We are mothers, we have children, we raise families and make homes. Yet we are singers who sing praises of dear God Almighty on religious stages. We are preachers and we can preach Gurbani of the sacred Adi Granth. We work in offices and hold good jobs. We are nurses, doctors and astronauts. We are writers, teachers, doctors and painters. We work everywhere, you name and we are there. Even in the Air Force, Navy and Army, we must remember this now and always, and hail Guru Nanak, hail Guru Gobind Singh, hail the Sikh Panth, that we are free, that we are at liberty and we have choices. Today we have equality because in the 15th century, Guru Nanak Dev Ji gave us freedom and equality, which some other women are still looking for even today as we live in the 21st century. Vaheguru Ji Ka Khalsa, Vaheguru Ji Ki Fateh.